12 of your Christmas countdown. What we've got here is a bit of a downhill lie, okay? So how do you play a golf ball off a downhill lie? Really simple. To start off with, club selection, really, really important. If you've, say you've got 100 yards to go, for example, and for me, 100 yards will be a pitching wedge, what you'll find off this downhill lie, because we're going to deal off the golf club, it's going to come out a lot lower and run out more. So this means your pitching wedge will be turned into something like a sand wedge. So usually one club difference. So just for example, if you've got a 7-iron usually for the distance, you'd then go to an 8-iron because again, it's going to run out as it hits the ground. So really important, big wide feet off the downhill lie. This is going to keep your balance. Ball fairly central, you can move it forward a touch in your feet, so this is just going to help the swing of the arc come down and through the shot. But the biggest thing is the shoulder tilt and the hip tilt, so shoulders getting them parallel to the slope and hips parallel to the slope as well. So as a result of this, the hands might come forward a touch, we can see how the club is then becoming de-lofted, okay? Swing wise, just think about sort of a 3/4 swing length for this. It will keep it under way more control as you go through. The balance, the all weight is going to be on that front bit, and the idea is we swing down with the slope on the way through. But the biggest thing is with the shoulders going with the slope, if I just show you a wrong position here, if I stand here, we'd always hit it heavy. You can see that with the different shoulder slant here and getting the club to go down with the slope on the way through. Okay, so next time you're on a downhill line, give this a go. Don't forget about club selection, don't forget about the shoulders and the hips facing down with the slope. And yeah, it's going to come out a lot further and a lot running.